Good morning, good evening, everyone. I think you are able to hear me and you can see my screen, right? Okay, thank you. So today, let's understand what is hybris. Okay, to define the hybris, you need to tell two things. First thing is that hybris is the e-commerce solution and it is the PCM software. And it is a PCM software. What is the meaning of e-commerce solution? What is the meaning of e-commerce solution? If you look at here, Flipkart. If you go to the Flipkart, this is the e-commerce solution. Let's take another example, Amazon. This is the e-commerce solution. That means if you want to develop a e-commerce solution, e-commerce site like Amazon, if you want to develop a e-commerce site like Flipkart, you can very well use e-commerce solution from the SAP. That's nothing but hybris. Therefore, e-commerce solution from SAP is nothing but hybris. That is the first point. The second point is, in the hybris definition, you have PCM. PCM stands Product Content Management. What does that mean? Let's understand. First thing is that product. Okay, if you see in the Flipkart, let's say you type iPhone 7. When you type iPhone 7, you will get the bunch of the products like this. So this is a product one, this is another product and all. So to manage these products, that means add the product, update the product and all. To manage the products, we need the software. So with the help of hybris, you can manage the products. Next, the second thing is that content. What is the meaning of content? When you go to the Flipkart, if you go to the Flipkart, you have something called banners. So this is the banner, this is the banner. These are all content. To manage this content means add the content, update the content and so on, so on. If you see here, right now 6 banners are there. Do you think that after 1 hour, same 6 banners will be there? No, it can be more. It can be more or it can be less. That means you need the software to manage this content. So hybris can help to manage the content. That's why we are calling it as Product Content Management Software. Product Content Management Software. That's it. Okay, now come here again. If you see here, hybris is the e-commerce solution. Now the question is, what is e-commerce? What is e-commerce? So the definition of the e-commerce is, what exactly we do in the e-commerce site? What exactly we do in the e-commerce site? You will buy the products from here. You can buy the product or you can sell the product. You can sell the product, right? If you see, there are C2C. So people can sell the product also. So therefore, buying or selling products or services by the business. Who is going to buy? Who is going to sell? By the business or consumer means customer over the internet. You are trying to do all these things over the internet. That's why we are calling it as e-commerce. So therefore, e-commerce is nothing but buying and selling. Okay, what you buy and what you sell? Products and services. By whom? By the business or consumer. On where? Through internet. That's nothing but World Wide Web. If you are doing a transaction over the internet, if you are buying something over the internet, then it is called e-commerce solution, or it is called e-commerce. Okay, now if you look at here, e-commerce is not new. Okay, if you look at here, now we are learning hybrid e-commerce from SAP. Now we are learning hybrid e-commerce from SAP. The question is, do you think that SAP was not having any e-commerce solution till now? Okay, so the answer is yes, they were having. So there are many e-commerce solutions. There are many e-commerce solutions from SAP, and hybrid is one of them. Hybrid is one of them. Then if you say there are e-commerce solutions from SAP, the question is, what are the SAP's e-commerce solutions? What are the SAP's e-commerce solutions? Okay, so the first one is, there is an online store from SAP. Online store, if you look at here, from 1996 to 2003. These are the approximate dates. Okay, so from SAP there are many e-commerce solutions. Then the first one is online store. So the range is 96 to 2003. That means it's like a 20 years old product. Okay, so then they have, after online store, they have something called SAP ISA, Internet Sales Application. This is also called as SAP CRM Web Channel. Okay, later they were having WCEM. Now they are having Hybris. Okay, so these are the different e-commerce solutions from SAP. Now the question is, why Hybris is famous? Okay, if you have many e-commerce solutions, like there is an online store, there is a ISA, there is a WCM, like that, many are there. Out of that, why Hybris is famous? Or let's understand one e-commerce. Let's take the ISA e-commerce and try to compare with the Hybris. So differences between SAP ISA e-commerce, and Hybris. Differences between SAP ISA e-commerce and Hybris. The first difference. Okay, so the first difference, let me show you if you develop a e-commerce using ISA, how the site looks. If you develop a e-commerce solution using Hybris, how the site looks. Okay, so let me take one example. Let me go to the google.com. So there is a SAP's B2C e-commerce. If you go down and look at this one. It's opening. Okay, so this is the e-commerce solution. This is the e-commerce solution developed using ISA. Okay, you can take a look at this. Now let me show you a e-commerce solution which is developed using Hybris. So like a Decathlon shop. If you see the Decathlon site, this is developed using Hybris. That means, okay, I'm trying to compare the differences between ISA e-commerce and Hybris. Okay, if you develop a e-commerce using ISA, this is the look and feel. If you develop a e-commerce solution using Hybris, this is the look and feel. Now let's understand some of the differences, why Hybris is famous. Okay, the first thing, if you look at here, let's say I want to search some product. Okay, let's say electronics. See, nothing is coming. But if I come here, I search something, ELE. See, it is giving suggestions. So suggestions, search, these are the advanced features, advanced search engine, or suggestions. These are all there in the Hybris, but if you go to the ISA, it's not there. Okay, so if you type ISA electronics, you will not get anything. If you press go button, then only you will get something. So that means the search engine is not powerful in ISA. If you see in the Hybris, search engine is very powerful and it can give the suggestions. Okay, the first one is search engine. Search engine is not powerful in ISA. And in Hybris, it is good. The second thing is that let's take the user experience. See the look and feel of this one. It's not up to the standards. See the look and feel of this one. When you go to the landing page, see how it looks. It looks awesome. So look and feel is also important nowadays. People call it as customer experience or user experience. So whenever people comes to your site, it should be more attractive. It should not be like this. If you see here, who is going to like this site? So the customer experience is also very much important. Customer experience is also very much important. Our user experience is very much important. And in case of ISA, we don't have advanced user experience standards. But if you look at here, here we have the good or latest web standard look and feel. Latest web standard look and feel. So therefore, in case of ISA, it's not ISA is not having latest web standards look and feel, but Hybris is having. Next, third one. If you look at the third one, okay, let me show you this one. So assume that someone is, this is ISA, right? This is ISA. Assume that someone is hitting from the mobile. So let me go to the mobile size, okay? So this is a mobile size screen. This is the mobile size screen. Okay, so when someone go to the mobile, or when someone hit this one from the mobile, see the look and feel. That means it is not mobile friendly. So ISA solution is not mobile friendly. Assume that someone is accessing the Decathlon. Decathlon is what? A hybrid solution. See, it is looking very good in the mobiles also. That means Hybris can support the mobile compatibility. Hybris supports the mobile compatibility. So ISA is not mobile friendly, but Hybris is mobile friendly. Okay, that is the next thing. Fourth thing is, let's understand something called a synchronous communication, asynchronous communication. Okay, so in the BTech MCA, you have something called synchronous communication and asynchronous, ASYNC, asynchronous communication. Anyone knows what the synchronous communication, asynchronous communication? Okay, let me explain you. Assume that you are here, I am here. Assume that you are here, and I am here. Okay, so if you throw something, let's say you are throwing a ball. If you are throwing a ball, I am there to catch it, then it is called a synchronous communication. That means whenever you are available, I am also available. If you are working, I will also work for you. So both should be available in case of synchronous communication. Both should be available in case of synchronous communication. Then what is the asynchronous communication? If you look at the asynchronous communication, let's say you are throwing a ball. Don't worry. Okay, if I am there or not, don't worry. You throw the ball. Okay, whenever I come back, I will take your ball. That's called asynchronous communication. That means, so the best example is what? You are calling me. If I am available, then we can talk each other. That is called synchronous communication. If I am not available, then what happens? You will drop a message, right? Hey, I am so-and-so. I called you for this reason. Please call me back once you see this message. Like that, you will drop the message. Then after 1 hour, I see that message and I'll call you back. That's called some kind of asynchronous communication. Don't worry whether I am there or not. You throw your ball. I will take your ball once I am available. That's called asynchronous communication. Now, coming to the hybrid perspective. Okay, one more point you need to remember is that this is the e-commerce solution, right? Or let's take the Flipkart. In the Flipkart, what exactly you do? Okay, you buy the product. You can buy the iPhone, right? Buying the product is nothing but placing the order. So therefore, in the e-commerce, you place the order. Once you place the order, there are n number of activities to take care. So in the e-commerce, you just place the order. Once you place the order, there are n number of activities to take care, like shipping, delivery, okay, base store, all these things. Those n number of activities will happen in third-party systems generally. That means, let's say this is your Hybris. This is your e-commerce solution. This is your e-commerce solution. What exactly you can do in the e-commerce? In the e-commerce, you can place the orders. That is the thing you can do. Once you place the order, there will be some third-party systems like SAP or some other thing. Okay, third-party systems like SAP or PeopleSoft or some other systems. Okay, so once you place the order in the e-commerce, then there are n number of activities to take care, like shipping, delivery, pricing, customer care. Okay, like that, there are n number of activities to take care. Those activities will happen in the other systems like SAP, PeopleSoft, and so on, so on, so on. That means once you place the order in the e-commerce, your order will go to that third party system. Your order will go to the third party system. In the third party system, rest of the activities will be taken care. Hence, there is a data exchange between Hybris and SAP. There is a data exchange between Hybris and SAP. Okay? Now, assume that your e-commerce solution is ISA. Assume that your e-commerce solution is ISA. If your e-commerce solution is ISA and you are placing the order, that means let's say this is the e-commerce ISA solution, right? So once you place the order, assume that if Hybris or if SAP is not available for 10 hours, if this is not available for 10 hours, if this is not available for 10 hours, and even though ISA is available, there is no use because ISA supports synchronous communication. ISA supports synchronous communication. That means if SAP is not available for 10 hours, then even though ISA is available, there is no use. You cannot place the orders because ISA supports synchronous communication. Synchronous communication means what? If I am available, you should be available. If you are not available, I will not work. That's called synchronous communication. Both should be available. That is the ISA solution. So therefore, ISA e-commerce supports only synchronous communication. That means if ISA is available, the third party system has to be available. Otherwise, you cannot place the orders. Now, next thing. So instead of ISA, assume that you have Hybris. Hybris supports asynchronous communication. That means even though SAP or third party system is not available for 10 hours and Hybris is available, still people can place the orders. People can place the orders. Once SAP back, then it will take care of the rest of the activities. Okay? So therefore, Hybris supports asynchronous communication. What is the meaning of asynchronous communication? Even though you are not available, I can do my activities. Once you back, you can take care of your activities. That is what the meaning of asynchronous communication. Hybris supports asynchronous communication. Now, next thing. If you observe here, as we discussed, right? So there is a data exchange between Hybris and the SAP or third party system. So there should be a data exchange between these two systems. To exchange the data between these two, you required something in the middle. That means you are trying to pass the information from Hybris to SAP, SAP to Hybris. To pass the data, to exchange the data between these two, we required something in the middle. That solutions are you can use Data Hub, or you can use SAP PI, or you can use any third party middlewares. Okay, so therefore, if you want to exchange the data between Hybris and SAP, SAP and Hybris, then you need to use some mechanisms. So the first one is Data Hub. The first one is Data Hub, and the second one is PI. Third one is, if you don't want to use Data Hub and PI, you can use any middlewares also, some third-party middlewares. Okay, next. So when do I use Data Hub? When do I use Data Hub? When do I use PI? Okay, assume that you have a SAP infrastructure. Okay, assume that you have SAP infrastructure and you also have PI. If you already have the PI infrastructure ready, then best way to exchange the data is PI. Assume that you have the SAP infrastructure but don't have the PI. Don't have the PI. Then you can go for the Data Hub. So like that, if you want to exchange the data between these two systems, then you can use these three mechanisms, either one of them. You can use Data Hub or PI or any third party middlewares. So the conclusion is, Hybris supports asynchronous communication. So ISA supports synchronous communication, and Hybris can do asynchronous communication. Okay, next thing. So because of many reasons, like because ISA is not having advanced search engines, ISA is not having latest web standards, ISA is not mobile friendly, ISA does not support asynchronous communication, like that we have many reasons. Because of many reasons, SAP decided to not to support ISA after 2020. Okay, I'm repeating this conclusion again. So if you look at here, there are some challenges with ISA. ISA is not having advanced search engines. Then ISA's look and feel is not up to the latest standards. Next thing is that it is not mobile friendly. Next thing is that it can support only synchronous communication. Because of many more reasons. SAP decided not to support ISA after 2020. That means after 2020, that means 3 years from now, ISA will not be supported. So therefore, all the clients who are using ISA, they have to transform to some other solutions. And obviously, SAP's direction is Hybris. SAP's e-commerce direction is Hybris. SAP's e-commerce direction or roadmap is Hybris. That's why Hybris is more powerful nowadays. Please remember this year, because you need to know what is happening in the ISA, what is happening in the SAP's e-commerce solutions also. Even though SAP is having many e-commerce solutions, SAP decided going forward not to spend energy on these old e-commerce solutions, and they want to be focused only on the Hybris. Hence, SAP's e-commerce direction in the roadmap is Hybris. That's why Hybris customers are increasing day by day. Next. The next thing is that if you look at here, so e-commerce is a concept. Let's take the example Oops. Oops is the concept. And this concept is implemented by so many languages. Oops concept is implemented in Java. Oops concept is implemented in SAP. Oops concept is implemented in .NET. And so on, So therefore, Oops is the concept, like polymorphism, inheritance, object, class. Okay, like that we have data hiding, all these are the Oops concepts. Those concepts are implemented in many programming languages. E-commerce is a concept. That concept is implemented by many companies. many companies. Then what are the e-commerce, what are the e-commerce solutions available from different companies? That is the question. The answer is from SAP we have Hybris. The same way from Oracle we have ATG. The same way from IBM we have WebCommerce. The same way from open source we have Magento. Like that we have many e-commerce solutions available in the market. Like that we have many e-commerce solutions available in the market. Okay, so the question is, the point is, e-commerce is the concept. That concept is implemented by many companies. And what are the companies implemented the e-commerce solution? So if you see here, Hybris is having SAP. Hybris is having SAP. And SAP is having Hybris. Oracle is having ATG. IBM is having e-commerce, web commerce. Open source is having Magento, and so on, so so on, so so on, so. And remember one more point. Remember one more point. If you look at here, Hybris was the company. Okay, initially they were in the Switzerland. It's there from last 20 years. Hybris is not the new. Hybris is there from last 20 years. Okay, last 20 years. Please remember that Hybris is not new. Hybris was the company. It's there from last 20 years. And initially they started in the Switzerland. Later they moved to Germany. Then in 2013, August 1st, SAP bought it. That's the story, or that's the history about the Hybris. I'm repeating the conclusion again. If you see here, so Hybris is the product. It is available from last 20 years. Hybris is the product. It is available from last 20 years. And initially, Hybris was there. They started in the Switzerland country. Then later, they moved to Germany. In 2013, August 1st, SAP bought it. From there onwards, we are calling it as SAP Hybris. Okay. Now, come to here, you can ask a question. What is the question? If you see here, from SAP we have Hybris, from Oracle we have ATG, from IBM we have WebCommerce, from open source we have Magento, and so on, so so on, so. Then why do I need to learn only Hybris? Why companies are started using Hybris a lot? So already e-commerce is number one. Okay, so but very soon Hybris is going to dominate that one. Hybris is going to be number one very soon. Why? Let's take the example. Let's say you want to implement e-commerce solution for Doc Redis Lab client. Assume that you are using ATG. If you are using ATG, then cost will be, assume that cost is, if you are using ATG, assume that cost is 100 rupees. Then the development time is 100 hours. Okay, then if you develop same thing using Hybris, the cost is going to be 60 rupees. And the development time is going to be 60 hours. That means with the help of Hybris, you can reduce 40% of the cost as well as development time. 40% of the cost and development time. That is the power of the Hybris. I am repeating the conclusion again. If you see here, you want to develop a project for Doc Redis Lab, and assume that you are using ATG or WebCommerce, IBM WebCommerce. Don't compare Magento with these kind of technologies, because Magento is open source. Open source is completely different. You no need to compare that one with the Hybris. Okay, so you want to implement a project for the Doc Redis Lab. Assume that you are using ATG. If you use ATG, assume that the development cost is 100 rupees and the development time is 100 hours. If you want to develop the same thing using Hybris, then your development cost or your cost is going to be 60 rupees and the development time is going to be 60 hours. That means almost Hybris can reduce Hybrids can reduce 40% of the cost as well as development time. That is the power of the hybrids. Okay, next thing. So what are the key pillars of hybrids? So there are 6-7 concepts, the important concepts. The first one is hybrids is built with the open source technologies like Spring. So therefore it is built on top of the Spring framework. Hybrids is built on top of the Spring framework. And hybrids is having powerful back office tools. What is the meaning of back office? Let me explain you. Hybrids is having powerful back office tools. What is the meaning of back office tools? Let me explain you. Let's go to the Flipkart. Right now, assume that there are 6 banners. Okay, so these are the banners, right? Okay, so these are the banners. 1, 2, 3. Like that, assume that there are 6 banners. Do you think that after 1 hour, there will be only 6? May not be. It can increase or it can decrease. Now the question, do you think that there is a developer who is doing that? No. So then the point is, you can do this kind of back office work. You can do this kind of back office job easily with the help of back office tools which are coming or which are available in the hybrids. Therefore, back office is like a small software, which helps us to do the back office job easily. Okay, so if you look at here, the best example, you have the content. Right now the banners are 6. After 1 hour, you don't want 6, you want 7. You want to add one more. So with the help of back office softwares or tools, you can do this kind of jobs easily. That's the power of the hybrids again. Okay, next thing is that integration. So hybrids is having powerful integration with the SAP. That's what I already explained you. Just let me close this. That's what I explained you already. If you want to exchange the data between hybrids and SAP, we have powerful mechanisms. That means we have easy integration mechanisms to exchange the data between SAP and hybrids and hybrids and SAP. So the integrations are powerful here. Then it is also mobile friendly. We already seen the example. Then one more thing is that it is a omni-commerce or omni-channel. Okay, what is the meaning of omni-channel or omni-commerce? We will see later. Okay, because it requires 20 minutes of explanation. We will see that one in detail in coming days. The next thing is that, so it is having powerful B2B and B2C accelerators. So if you compare with the ATG, the B2B in hybrids is more powerful. It is having excellent features in case of B2B in hybrids. Okay, so these are some of the key pillars in the hybrids. Next thing. So the next question is, if you look at here, so Flipkart is the e-commerce solution. In the e-commerce, what exactly we do? We place the order. So if you want to place the orders here, first what, you need to make this product aware of the people. You need to make the product aware of the people. So therefore, let's say in the e-commerce, with the e-commerce solution, you are trying to do the business. Right? Okay. Now for any business, what are the key important points? Let's say you have a business called Walmart. Okay, let's say you have a business like a store kind of thing. You have some other business. For any business, what are the key important points for you? If you take any business, whether it is a food court business, whether it is a mall business, whether it is a items business, whatever it may be, there are three key important points you need to follow to increase the business or to successful in the business. What are the three key important points? The first one is, how do you attract the customer? The second one is, how do you retain the customer? How do you attract the customer? How do you retain the customer? Or how do you attract the customer? How do you, one second. How do you attract the customer? How do you, okay? So for any business, there are three key important points. First one is, how do you attract the customer? Second one is, how do you convert the customer? Third one is, how do you retain the customer? So what does that mean? Let's understand now. Okay, let's say you have a hotel business. When you have the hotel business, the first thing is that, how do you get the customers to your hotel? So obviously you need to attract it. That's what we are telling. So if you see the ISA e-commerce solution, if you have this kind of look and feel, you cannot attract it much. So therefore, you need to make it more colorful with a great customer experience. With great customer experience. Look at the Flipkart, look at this one. So therefore, the first point for any business is, how do you attract the customer? How do you attract the customer here? You can attract the customer by providing contextually relevant information and by providing great customer experience. Okay, so let's understand these two now. What is this meaning? Okay, if you look at here, okay, so what is the meaning of contextually relevant information? Let's understand what is the meaning of contextually relevant information. Let's say you go to the Flipkart. Assume that you logged in as a male gender. When you log in as a male gender, you will see most of the male related products. That means contextually I am providing the relevant information. That is one scenario. Second scenario, go to the Flipkart. Assume that yesterday you bought iPhone. Today you are buying one more iPhone. Day after tomorrow you buy one more iPhone. Then when you go fourth time, you will see most of the phone related products. That means based on the context, I am providing relevant products for you. So that is how I can attract the customer. So to attract the customer, contextually relevant information you need to provide. And also you need to provide a great customer experience. Great customer experience means what? If I don't know what to search or where can I find my product, you can just type iPhone 7. Contextually relevant information, great customer experience. If I type iPhone, see, I'm getting the products. If I get iPhone, then I'm getting the products. That means I'm providing great customer experience. Therefore, by providing great customer experience and contextually relevant information, you can attract the customer. So therefore, this is the one. If you look at here, this is not a great customer experience. But if you see the hybrids, it's a great customer experience. You have menus, you have search engine, you have advanced user experience standards, and so on, so on, so on. Next thing, how do you convert the customer? Once you attract the customer, you need to make sure you need to convert them. That means convert means doing the business with them. Convert means doing the business with them regardless of channel or devices. Regardless of channel or devices. What does it mean? Let's say if someone is hitting this ISA e-commerce in the mobile, they cannot do the transaction. Can you say that, okay, please try from the desktop instead of the mobile? No, you cannot say like that because customers are important for you. It's not the matter whether they are using desktop. It's not the matter whether they are using desktop or mobile or tablet. You should do the business with them regardless of the channel. Regardless of the channel, you should do the business with them. Don't tell that, okay, hey, you are trying to from iPhone. Okay, please try from the desktop. Don't say that kind of statements. That's not going to help. You cannot convert them. You cannot do the business with them if you have a scenario like that. Hence, so if you see the hybrids, Hybris can do that. Hybris can do that. That's how you can convert the customers. Convert the customers means regardless of the channel or device, you should do the business with them. Once you do the business with them, the next thing is that how do you retain the customer? That means you need to get back them again and again. Let's say you are working in some company, XXS company. They have given 10% hike to you this year. If they don't give next year, will you stay? No, you will not stay. You will go and join in some other company. That means company has to meet your expectation continuously, then only you will be with that company. Same thing here. Same thing here. So you need to meet customers' expectations. Customers' expectations constantly throughout the journey. This is important. Okay, so try to understand here. How do you retain the customers? You need to meet their expectations continuously. That means constantly throughout their journey. It's not like 1 year you give hike, another year you don't give hike. No, if that is the case, you cannot retain the customers. So therefore, you need the solution. To satisfy the first point. That's nothing but hybris. If you see ISA, no. There is no attraction here. But hybris is the solution for the first point. Then you need the solution for second point. Convert the customers. Yes, hybris is the solution for the second point. You need the solution or technology for third point. Yes, hybris is the solution or technology for the third point. So because of these reasons, hybris is more powerful nowadays. That's it for today. If you have any questions, you can ask me now. Thank you for your time. Okay, bye.